Hello, I'm Atubo George, and I'm so blessed to be bringing God's truth to you today. Now, this is a new week, and we are just 2 days to the end of the month of April. Now, April ends tomorrow. And then, let me use this opportunity also to invite you for our prayer and fasting meeting that we hold every first of the month. Actually, we begin by 12 midnight on the last day of the month and throughout the first day of the month, and we pray according to the watches. Praise God. So we'll start at 12 midnight. We also pray for 1 hour at each watch. So 12 midnight, 3 a.m., 6 a.m., 9 a.m., 9 a.m., 12 noon, and 3 p.m., 6 p.m., and the last prayer watch for the first is going to be at 9 p.m. Now, these are meetings that you don't want to miss, because during these meetings, the Lord begins to give us a mindset or an understanding of what the month is going to look like. Praise God. And you're free to join. The meeting is via Zoom. Now, the Zoom address is on your screen. If you can just copy it down so that you set an alarm concerning these meetings. And I believe strongly in my heart that from the month of May, there are certain things the Lord will begin to do in our lives, which is very, very important. I'm sure by the time we get into that meeting, you'll begin to have a clear understanding of what I'm talking about. Praise God. So for today, are you ready to make demand for your daily bread? Join me right now in the name of the Lord Jesus as we stand in faith and declare these words. Say after me, say, Father, I make demand right now for my daily bread. It is coming to me and I receive all of it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. As we begin to round off this series we've been on about the wisdom of God's word, I want to take us back to our original text. First Peter. Thank you, Lord Jesus. First Peter chapter 2 and from verse 1 to 3. Now, I kept telling you this, but I read this to remind us, because this is the foundation of the wisdom of God, the wisdom of God's word. Now, when we talk about the wisdom of God's word, we are saying how you receive the word of God. And we'll say the wisdom of his word is getting to receive the truth, the understanding behind his word. See? So his word gives us wisdom. When we take it in, when we understand his word, we become wise. Now, you remember Paul was talking to Timothy and he says, hey, Timothy, you, from a little child, you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise. Why is the Scriptures able to make you wise? Because of the wisdom that the Scriptures carry. So everything you read in Scriptures is a lesson that carries a wisdom. So you heard me say on this broadcast, it's not about quoting the Scriptures. It's about understanding the wisdom behind every statement that was made. Because God himself declared that man shall live by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Now, if man is going to live by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God, then it's important that you know that there is something in every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Okay? Now, that thing that proceeds from the mouth of God is full of wisdom. It's full of wisdom. If you don't get the wisdom behind it, you will not live. I find a lot of believers who love to quote scriptures. They quote and quote and quote. Sometimes they even argue with it. But then you look at their lives is nothing to write home about as regard the scriptures that they quote. See? Now, when I say their lives is nothing to write home about, I'm not just saying they are not wealthy like you think they should be. No, I'm saying their lives, their living is not just consistent with the wisdom of God's word. And that's because even though they quote the scriptures, they don't understand. See, because the truth is this, you apply your mind to the wisdom behind the scriptures, not the scriptures. The scriptures can just be for knowledge. But it's the wisdom behind it that brings understanding to you. So if you understand that, then you're good to go. But if you quote all the scriptures but lack understanding of the wisdom behind them, then you still suffer in life. Do you know the scriptures? Some people just feel it's by quoting that they become. No, it's not by quoting. God said this to Joshua. He says, you shall meditate on it day and night. Now, why was God telling him to meditate on him? So that he will understand. Because the next thing God said is, so that you will observe to do according. Notice, he didn't say so that you will observe to do what is written. He says you will observe to do according. Now, English words, okay? But then, if you don't even understand the English, how do you operate it? So when he says you will observe to do according to all that is written, it's different from saying you will observe to do exactly what is written. So God, for example, declared when he was giving Moses the Ten Commandments, he says, thou shalt not covet, or thou shalt not kill. Now you find here, someone goes, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not kill. Ah! I can't kill it. And someone say, even to kill a fly. I can't kill a fly because God says, thou shalt not kill. I don't want to be associated with anything killing because God said, thou shalt not kill. Now, what's lacking? You saw the word, you saw the scriptures, you took it in, and you're trying to do what is written. So, when you are enlisted to become a soldier, for example, and then you go to war, and you have your guns with you, and there's this nation fighting against your nation, and you are a soldier, and here you are with your gun, and see the war is on, and you see an opponent who's ready to kill you, and you just need to point your gun and shoot at him, and then you go, no, the scriptures say, thou shalt not kill. I don't want to kill. And maybe you'll even be dead before you finish reasoning out your thoughts. Praise God. Yeah, you'll be dead. And then what happened? You'll even find people who confess and say, I'd rather, it's better I die instead of me to kill another person because God says, thou shalt not kill. Now, what's going on here? You are taking the word literally, but you lack understanding of the wisdom behind it. So what's the wisdom behind it? The wisdom behind it is don't do murder. Don't do murder. See? Of course, David challenged Goliath and he killed Goliath. Was that murder? You understand what I'm saying? So now, because people lack understanding, I use that as an example, because you lack understanding of the wisdom behind the scriptures, you, even in trying to do the scriptures, you go into error. Now, many people have gone into error like that. You see it in the way they dress, you see it in the way they do things, the way they comport themselves. You see a lot of error in their lives. And when you ask them, say, what's going on? Say, no, I'm living my life according to the scriptures. No, you're not living your life according to the scriptures. You're trying to live your life as the scripture says. Now, someone will look at that statement and say, but is it not a good thing? Is it not? If you lack the wisdom of the scriptures, in trying to keep the scriptures, you will get yourself into bondage. The scriptures are to deliver us from bondage. But the same scriptures can get you locked in bondage if you do not understand it. So that's why Paul, you find Paul writing and said, for the letter kills, but the spirit gives life. What's he talking about? How can you say the letter kills? When he says the letter kills, he's talking about the scriptures. The letter of the scripture will kill you. It is the spirit that quickens, Jesus said. So when you lack this understanding, in you trying to do the scriptures without understanding the scriptures will lead into error. And that's why Peter was speaking here in 1 Peter chapter 2. It says from verse 1, it says, therefore laying aside all malice, all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and all evil speaking. It says laying it aside. Lay it aside. As newborn babes, desire the pure milk of the word, that you may grow thereby, if indeed you have tasted that the Lord is gracious. So he says, lay aside all these things. The reason is very simple. The moment your heart is not pure and you come to receive the scriptures, you come to receive the word of God, something is going to be wrong. So he says he wants you to receive the pure, the unadulterated. Now, what are the things that adulterates the word? Now, the moment you have an agenda before you go to the word, you naturally adulterate the word. See, if you have malice in your heart, and that you find yourself trying to get scriptures that will support wickedness towards another person, that's when you start finding scriptures that have to do with your enemies and how God is going to rain down wickedness on them. And you desire such to happen without first coming to the place of full understanding of the mind of God concerning those things. So when you now see the things Jesus was speaking, I think I shared that battle that with you last week. When Jesus said, if you love your enemies and lend to them, don't ask them back, requesting nothing or not desiring to even get back what you lend to them. See? So what does it mean by that? These folks are my enemies. So why should I lend to them? You understand what I'm saying? Because you don't know. Now you have a difficulty accepting that, because that's all you're seeing. So my enemy now, because it's my enemy, I now go and lend to him. This word of God is too hard to do. No, because you lack understanding of the wisdom behind that statement. Now the wisdom behind such a statement, or this particular statement, is God had said, vengeance is mine, I'll repay. So you don't want to catch yourself in any way seeking vengeance with your own hands. And the wisdom behind that is this. You'll be completely free from the blood of men. I told you last week, was it last week or so? I told you earlier on this broadcast, on this subject, this topic, that the wicked, God spoke to Ezekiel and told him how to handle the wicked and the word of God concerning judgment on the wicked. So the wicked will die in their iniquity, but then God is going to require their blood. Every blood is accounted for, everybody on this earth, their blood is accounted for. That's the reason Jesus, when he was praying in John chapter 17, he had to account for all the disciples, including Judas Iscariot. So he was talking to the Lord. He says, and this is, the Lord was talking to the Lord. You see, just like David said, the Lord said unto my Lord. Okay. So Jesus here was talking to God. He says, all that you have given me, I have lost none, except the son of perdition, that the scriptures may be fulfilled. Did you see that? So Jesus said, the only one I lost, I didn't just lose him out of my carelessness. I didn't just lose him because I was angry. No, I lost him because number one, he was the son of perdition. So he was not even supposed to be with us in the first place. Number two, the scriptures have written things concerning him that must be fulfilled. He that has eaten bread with me have lifted up his heels against me. That is a scripture, and it must be fulfilled. So Jesus found himself in that place where his life was fulfilling that scripture. So Jesus had a thief with him who was stealing from the bag, and he did nothing about it. He knew, not that he didn't know, not that one day it was after the death of Judas, Jesus resurrecting. And I said, wait, come, all those are our monies. What really used to happen to them? I used to say, do you know even Judas was building a house? Really, where did he get the money from? Praise God. Jesus giving account of these ones. He says, only the son of perdition is missing. He's the only one we lost. And we lost him because the scriptures have to be fulfilled. See that? Praise God. Because the scriptures have to be fulfilled. So every life is accounted for, the good, the bad, and the ugly life. They are all accounted for. Yes, they are all accounted for. So when God accounts for the life, let it not be that your own voice was given for the death of that person. And let it not be found that you are a beneficiary to the death of that wicked person. Now, these are things you learn even from the scriptures. You see David exhibit this character and you see the blessedness of it. Now, this is why you must be careful how you receive the word in your heart. So Peter is saying here that clear your mind of all malice, clear your mind of all deceit. You don't want to be involved in anything that shows deceit. You don't want to be. Even if it's to your own advantage, you don't want it. Why? Because you believe that these things will draw your attention from receiving the pure word of the Lord. For the moment you have an agenda in your heart, sorry, you will not receive the pure word. Especially when your agenda is now evil. What do I mean evil? You have malice in your heart, which is evil. Doesn't matter what whoever has done to you. You have hypocrisy in your heart. You have envy. You speak evil. That's the problem you will face. You cannot receive the pure word of the Lord in that situation. You can't receive it. If you don't clear, whenever you approach scriptures, whenever you approach the word of the Lord, whenever you go before the Lord in prayer to seek for something in terms of character, knowing his character, knowing him, you know, so God, I just want to know you. I just want to know you. And look at how you treat people around you. Clear your heart of all those things. So that when the word of the Lord is coming to you, it comes pure. It comes pure. See, that's what God desires. Do you know that? That the word of God comes pure to your heart. And when it comes pure, it affects your understanding. So your understanding of this word will be pure. It will not be filtered by your hate. It will not be filtered by your envy, by your hypocrisy and deceit. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. My time is up. Praise God. I pray for you today. Receive the pure word of the Lord. It doesn't matter how rooted you have been in the wrong things. I declare today, by the Spirit of the living God, you are made free You are made free. Your heart is made free right now. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will garrison your heart and fill it with the peace of God so that you will receive the pure word and understand the pure word and function in that pureness. In Jesus' name. Amen. I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye.